Diesel is already being used for many, many years. So they know what they can expect with diesel engines, and for environmental purposes, it's good they look to another kind of system, which is much cleaner.
This genset also is prototyped together with ACR. We should be and think about this system like a one big unit, one big solution.
The response on what you require during an assist must be fast. So that's important, that the engine can react quite fast. Where from one moment to another, a lot of power is required.
We don't have any power losses. We have no reports of increased fuel consumption. That is exactly what we expect of this kind of system. We want to go easy on the environment and comply with regulations while operating our vessels as successfully as we have done in the last 100 years. Users require a working system with high stability and valid certification. It's helpful for us if certification is obtained from the same source as the engines. So we are looking for integrators who can offer us an all-round solution.
The deal, the special agreement between Fairplay and MTU, will be until 10 or 15,000 running hours. But I expect the system still will be ready and still will be good.
They can read out everything from their home base. They can log in to the computer system on board to see if it's some problem or some problem coming on the short term, or the results from performance from the engines and everything. This is working quite good.
We have a system that has been working very well for 2.5 years now. Online, we can see that performance is still within the permitted limits. We can apply this data and compare it with the results on the test stand. How can we make this work the way it needs to? What can we offer that is of benefit to the customer? We pre-test the components in a specially built lab. We test their operating performance and how precisely they meet the requirements of marine applications. We have been testing these systems for years. We test each component individually. If the components are suitable, if they last for the intended lifespan of the whole installation, then we integrate those to design the overall system. We designed the exhaust after-treatment system around the engine. Emissions compliance is a very important issue for us within the certification and testing process. We developed the exhaust after-treatment system along with the engine. After-treatment is developed to match diesel engine performance. We want to push the system's limits. We simulate realistic operating temperatures and pressures here on the test stand, so we get true-to-life results. The combination we see here will be tested for at least a year. For the certification and testing we run on the test stand, we procure fuels of varying qualities, including very low-quality fuel, so we're ready for worst-case scenarios in real-life operation. Then we know the systems will work with those fuels. While testing the cycle, we can see how the engine behaves during maneuvers. If it behaves as we expect it should, we need no compressed air in the engine room to feed the diesel exhaust fluid to the dosing units. Therefore, no separate compressor is needed in the engine room to feed the DEF to the SCR. Nonetheless, we want to offer customers a high degree of flexibility because in the marine industry, engine rooms have very differing specifications. We start with two standard solutions. We offer an alternative exhaust after-treatment design. This cubicle system, it is a custom solution for each engine. Every box can be combined with a single, compact after-treatment system, a kind of plug-and-play box that connects all relevant components within the box. With our flat box design and the cubicle design, we have integrated the entire mixing pipe, so we don't require a separate section for mixing. This endoscope that you see here allows us to look inside via this monitor during operation. It lets us make sure no deposit is building up during operation. This gives us extra space, and we custom design the system to fit the space perfectly. It is very compact, very light. It integrates the sound absorber, and the system is already insulated. No insulation inside the vessel. The system is already insulated. That saves lots of time in the shipyard, and that makes it all nice and compact. Our catalysts, the main components in the reduction system, age with use. This is a chemical process that cannot be interrupted. In our systems, it's possible to remove the catalyst cartridges and insert new ones in a way that allows the system to keep running and without having to open up maintenance hatches, as the cartridges are easy to handle and replace. After testing, we take the components back. We examine every component. We look at the structure, the casing, the welding seams, the catalyst. The catalyst itself goes to an external lab to be tested for efficiency. Then we can estimate how long it will actually last. The addition of urea is one way to reduce nitrous oxide emissions, along with measures taken inside the engine. It is thus probably unavoidable in the long term. There are two basic systems, closed-loop control and open-loop control systems. In an open-loop control system, the amount of urea injected depends on engine load. Our system has sensor technology downstream of the SCR unit. That means we don't just inject the necessary amount of urea into the system. We also measure if the reaction is as we expected afterwards. We can adjust it, and while doing that, we can monitor all the components used in the system. To ensure that works equally well at varying exhaust temperatures and mass flows, it has to be tested. You have to test that over the long term, because there are aspects that work perfectly for 15 minutes, but then there might be deposits or buildups somewhere in the system that you don't see until hours later. These are urea deposits. Generally, these can form in an SCR system, especially if you don't have it perfectly under control. This is very solid. It's not a powder. The problem is that these build up during idling, and when under full load, the engine might just stop working. When solutions from several manufacturers are put together on site, we cannot be certain that, beyond what was tested and proven in certification, the system actually works as planned. When you use an open-loop controlled system from a third-party supplier, you don't have any iterative development. The system is designed, it matches the engine, and on that specific day, it meets the engine's demands that day. The problem customers saddle themselves with is that they have to deal with all the various issues that may arise. Various suppliers deliver various components as part of one certification, but one must put that all together. In practice, the worst-case scenario is that someone examines the vessel somewhere, and it isn't emissions compliant, or the system doesn't behave as it should. If that happens, the ship has to be taken out of service immediately, which involves heading for the next port and fixing the problem there. In my opinion, certification belongs in the hands of engine manufacturers. The engine manufacturer is the party best placed to test engine emissions from end to end. That is, from combustion right through to final exhaust after the SCR has done its work. Going forward, we will continue to be a technology leader in the marine industry and to provide customers with harmonized systems and solutions. That way, we can continue in our core discipline of diesel engines and be an all-round systems provider that offers comprehensive solution packages to customers. I believe this will be the sole standard in future.